Howdy everybody, this is Jared with Flutie the Comestin, and this is my nephew, tell him how old you are.
I'm 13.
Alright, me and Holden, tomorrow is the opening day of turkey season here in Kentucky, so we're getting our gear together to go turkey hunting, and we're getting all of our vests ready and our calls, so we got our box calls, we got our slate calls, and Holden's got his mouth call. And Holden's a lot better at the mouth call. I'm just learning. He's a lot. Show him what you can do. And I can't even blow wind through mine. So we're getting all our gear together. We got our face mask ready and our gloves and our shotguns. So we're going to take you along this morning, tomorrow morning. And got our decoy out. And we're going to take you with us tomorrow morning on the first day of spring turkey season 2018.
What about your guns?
I'm using a Remington Model 1100.
And I'm taking my old faithful 1300 Winchester.
Say yours again, Hayden, real life.
Remington 1100, it's 12 gauge with full choke.
All right, we'll see y'all in the morning.
All right. So the way that you want to use this is you want to take the roof of your mouth and then say that my thumb is your tongue. You want to put your thumb on it, so, and then you want to make it just breathe. Well, like kind of like hiss, just to get started. And you just mix that and make it faster so it sounds like this. And then you can maybe add in some extra calls. You're getting it.
I got a bad gag reflex.
Now see, to fix that is, you can take some scissors just like this and trim the ends off of it if you have a bad gag reflex, and trim it down so it doesn't go as far back. You're getting
it. Yeah, there you go, Jer.
This is how Jared's coming along, using a mouth call. Now he's producing sound, which is good. It's a really good start. Some people have a really bad gag reflex and can't even make a sound.
Show them what yours sound like, compared to mine, though.
We're setting up in a new spot. We haven't had any gobble close by. So we set up on this logging road and Holden set a decoy out at the forks of this road. Foals everywhere.
We've got one goblin down over here in the ridge. We're gonna try to get him.
Alrighty. We've walked probably 2 miles back in these log roads, and I've spotted 2 turkeys on the far ridge over there where you can see on the log road. And we've heard one goblin its head off every time we call. So we're gonna ease on around this holler and get over on the next ridge and see if we can get 2 of them into us.
Today was a fun day.
Yeah, we
had also a little bit sad.
Yeah, we both missed a turkey. Mine, we had one. We was watching one up on the hill, and we set up, and there was another one, and a hen come within 15 feet of us, behind us, couldn't turn around. So when they moved, well, finally I got up, and I seen one's head pop up, and I shot and missed. So we reset up, and Holden put his decoy out in front of us, and we was watching a bird, and then the ones that we'd shot at come back up the hill and was coming strutting to Holden, and then he missed one. So we was a little trigger happy on the first morning.
But it was still a really good first morning.
It was an awesome morning. We've seen, 4 gobblers?
Well, we've seen 4 gobblers, 2 hens, and we've heard probably about 6 gobblers.
Yep. And we've walked probably 3 or 4 miles to get to them. But it's been a beautiful morning. And we're going to go home and eat some lunch and may try to come back here this evening and see if we can get one or at least find out where they're roosting. So overall, it's been a blessed day.